Automated Optoelectronic Testing Platform by Luis Soriano for the Electrical Engineering Department, Class EE-497, Senior Project Design 1. Description of the project. This project is aimed to the redesign and improvement of an automated platform that tests gallium nitride photodiode sample under radiation conditions. The platform provides an innovation in the way to characterize radiation data in a more efficient and accurate way. Also, it is supposed to perform remote and repeatable measurements with high precision. To do that, different sensors are used to run the experiments, 7 to be exact, that allow scientists to determine the effectiveness of each diode. Customer needs. Now in the market, there exists a high demand for better electronic equipment, with applications in nuclear experiments or space missions. The reason is that during these experiments, data is lost due to high levels of radiation that damage the equipment. This leads to the replacement of very expensive data acquisition equipment that may cost millions of dollars. The need for better materials to place in these high energy environments is necessary for understanding the nuclear stockpile in the US. Some of the solutions is buying very expensive testing equipment that need manual calibration, especially to test gallium nitride, since it is becoming a popular testing material for nuclear research. Customers. Most of the customers are national labs in the US that have researched new semiconductor devices and applications to fulfill the need of more sophisticated sensor for further explorations. Some of the labs are the Lawrence Livermore National Lab, Sandia National Lab, and other labs across the country. Current market. As I stated before, there are no devices in the market that can perform several tests automatically. Separate devices used for a specific test have to be manually calibrated and are very expensive. Project goals. The main purpose of this device is to be capable for self-alignment that would significantly reduce the time scientists spend in setting up each test. The automatic process will perform data acquisition in real time and remotely, reducing the risk of high radiation exposure for the scientist or operator. Design process. The design process involves improvement of the platform, proper setup and addition of new sensors, automation of actuators, and new algorithm for better data acquisition with high precision. The main elements that conform the platform are, first, the PCB, to interface sensors, actuators, and measurements and power supplies to the computer. Next, LabVIEW, which is a graphical programming software that is used to automate the entire system and obtain the necessary data. The front panel in the program is the primary way for users to interface with each of the testing automation processes. This is also where the individual dials the patterns, equipment calibrations, test selections, and data collection is performed. The last element in the platform is the platform itself, which is to be entirely redesigned for more sensing implementation. Current issues. In understanding this device in depth, several issues were encountered on the current setup. Some of them are shown in the pictures. First, there was a faulty connection on the power meter cord that needed to be replaced that generated misleading data points. Once replaced, expected data could be obtained, as seen on the graph on the right. Second, the inefficient connection on the DSAP cable, as seen in the lower left picture. The DSAP cable, built by the previous team, was very inefficient. Some of the pins were not working properly and was very difficult to identify them. Some of the issues was in powering the PCB, so it was directly connected to the power supply with different cables. Also, on the lower right picture, I found that the WinCam D camera needs to be set up properly. Some of the problems were in establishing the interface with the computer using the LabVIEW program. The device could not be loaded to the program only by installing the updates and running the specific version of LabVIEW was when it finally worked. In addition to that, the alignment process to set the initial position of the diode makes the test less precise since it needs to be carried manually for each round. A better calibration method for the linear actuators is necessary. When the system is powered off, it is being observed in some occasions that the actuators do not return to their original position. It is important to add a limit to the maximum distances that actuators can be displaced. In this way, errors that add up over the whole operation are reduced and do not lead to unreliable data collision. Redesign of the LabVIEW program is totally necessary, so it is required that the test be taken in the least amount of time. Currently, each test takes around 3 hours. It is intended to reduce this amount to just 1 hour. For the final remarks, I found numerous issues on the platform when I received it and inspected more carefully. Many of them have been resolved during this semester, but there is still a few more to be fixed. Once the entire process is in condition to work automatically, new implementations and improvements can be added. Finally, understanding the operation of the current device in depth was a key point to start the new improvements. Thank you.